Okay, hello cloud gurus, how y'all doing? Scott Pletcher here with another week of AWS news goodness. EC2 root volumes get a new trick, the Redshift feature set just keeps on growing. We have some new open data sets to play with and my dream of a post-apocalyptic DeepRacer Thunderdome Battle Royale gets a little closer to reality. All right here on AWS this week. AWS has enabled a new feature for EC2 that lets us do a quick switcheroo of our root volumes. We can roll back to the original launch state or a last known good snapshot without even stopping the instance. And this can come in handy if you accidentally lock yourself out with a config change, as I have done many times, or if you get a little too crazy with that rm-f command, as I have done many times. If you do have to roll back your root volume, any ephemeral volume data and network config is preserved, which is pretty darn cool. Now you can only use this feature on EBS volumes, no instance store volumes, and it does not work for metal instances. That said, this feature is sure to save some time and headache. When AWS announced Redshift way back in 2012, I thought it was a perfect cloud-based alternative to the very pricey on-prem data warehouse appliances available at that time. It was a little rough around the edges when it first released, but over time, more and more features have been added to give it some really interesting and unique capabilities in the enterprise data warehouse space. Recently, AWS announced some new features that might be worth a look. For starters, the Redshift Advanced Query Accelerator, or AQUA, is now generally available. AQUA is a high-speed caching layer that scales out in parallel to process queries at super fast speeds. Next, data feeds from select AWS partners have now been natively integrated with Redshift, allowing you to ingest and join data across partners like Informatica, SnapLogic, Mattilion, and more. Finally, Redshift now natively supports JSON and semi-structured data via the new super data type. You can also use PartyQL to query that semi-structured nested data, opening up some interesting possibilities. Go Redshift, go. AWS has published 28 new and updated datasets on its Registry of Open Data. This registry contains over 250 datasets from life sciences, agriculture, climate and weather, machine learning, and many more disciplines. Aside from being handy if you're a researcher, they're great for experimenting with various AWS analytics services. Since most of the datasets are stored on S3, you can use them to get hands-on with Athena, AWS Glue, Redshift, Spectrum, SageMaker, QuickSight, or any other service where you need a big batch of data. Speaking of open data, AWS has open sourced the DeepRacer software. This means that the DeepRacer hardware platform is way more hackable, letting us scheme up new ways for our little autonomous cars to do our bidding. Along with the original DeepRacer and DeepRacer Evo hardware platforms, we can also bolt on the 360-degree LiDAR kit to the original DeepRacer, add a 3D vision kit for depth perception, and upgrade the neural net processing power. As part of this open source release, AWS has published a handful of demo projects to help you get started on your hackery, including mounting a Nerf blaster to the thing. I will most definitely not be attaching a flamethrower to this little guy right here. And that, my friends, is all the AWS news that's fit to print this week. If you're so inclined, subscribe, drop a comment, or just give us a thumbs up. Stay safe, take care of one another, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.